I'll skim through like these parts too because we don't need to see this part again. So up next on the gaming list, I have a little bit of time to play Granblue Relink. So I'll play that for a little bit. And then Moon 7 Rebirth comes out. Moon 7 Rebirth.
Hey, it's been a while.
We can let it play out.
Midnight's just around the corner.
Let the whole thing
when
play
it
out,
hits, I'll lose this form. And I won't be me anymore. So, have you made a decision? Then I'll be waiting in his room until midnight. Come see me when you have your answer.
Yeah, it's Granblue Rebirth, and then Dragon's Dogma 2.
Oh, and one more thing. Don't let the fact that you have to kill me influence your decision. Like I said, I'm gonna disappear either way. I don't have any hang-ups about dying, so you don't need to worry about me. All right. I'll be waiting.
Have you made your decision? I see. Have the rest of you decided?
No need to ask me.
You know how I feel.
I wouldn't be here if it wasn't on board.
I'm with the rest of you.
I'm on board too.
I've made my decision as well.
Sounds like we're all on the same page.
Better let him know then, okay?
Hey, it's been a long time since we talked like this in your room. Though back then, I had a different form and a different name. It seems like you all decided to let me live. You're all going to risk your lives on a battle you can't win. But they're not the ones here right now. You are. I'll say this one more time. If you kill me, Tartarus, the Dark Hour, and the memories of your battles will all disappear. Tomorrow, you'll wake up as a normal high school student. You'll be able to live in peace until the moment of the fall. But if you let me live, you'll spend every waking moment until that day dreading your inevitable death. Nyx can't be defeated. It's pointless to fight her. Are you still thinking, or have you already made up your mind? So then, you understand. I think looking to the future is a great way to live. That doesn't mean other ways of living are wrong. No one knows which road will lead to happiness. I'm really glad I met you. This must be what it's like to feel happy. Thank you for everything.
Cold. But of course, you never miss a day of school, huh? I'm impressed. Man, this year really flew by. We're practically third years now. Only one more year of high school. You think there's anything interesting on the horizon? You think so? Looking at the current third years? I'm not really sure. Pretty much all they do is freaking study. Sure doesn't look like fun to me. Is that what we're gonna turn into next year? Man, why do I feel like I'm forgetting something? Hey, is that girl looking at us? Dude, she's pretty cute! How come I never noticed her before?
What are you talking about? She lives in the same dorm as us.
Wait, she does? What's her name then?
I don't know.
Sheesh, then you barely know more than me. Anyway, it's always crazy in the dorms this time of year. With so many people coming and going. Oh yeah, did you hear? Sonata-senpai's moving out. You know him, right? He's the captain of the boxing team.
Yeah, not that I really talk to him. And obviously, all the graduates are leaving. Kirijo-senpai's getting ready to move, too.
Kirijo. Oh, the student council president. She's in our dorm, too, huh?
Man, what's up with that girl?
Hey there! Are you looking at us? Is something wrong?
Oh, no. It's nothing.
She looked like she had something on her mind, huh? Wait, you think she might be interested in one of us?
Not a chance.
Man, you really know how to hit a guy where it hurts.
Next, a word from the valedictorian. From Class D, Mitsuru Kirijo-san.
Thank you.
This last year, I accepted an important responsibility as student council president. When I first addressed you from this podium, I spoke to you all about seizing opportunity while you had the chance. Well, it must have been fate that intervened and gave me an important reminder of this. As many of you may know, my father unexpectedly passed away due to illness. To tell the truth, after losing my father, I also lost much of my self-confidence. I had overestimated my ability to handle everything alone because I believed it was the right thing to do. Few people can be that strong. There are times when we can't stand without the support of others. After my father's death, I received kind words from many people. You all taught me the value of allowing yourself to be cared for and protected. I hope to continue forward with the support of those around me. For us graduates, it was truly an honor to share the last 3 years with all of you. Thank you so much for those wonderful years.
Man, that sounds rough. I guess even the student council president cries too, huh? Hey, she's not here.
Who's not?
You know, that girl we saw at the front gate. I thought she'd be at the graduation ceremony, but I guess not.
Oh, her. Well, there's a lot of people who didn't show. Actually, I'm surprised you didn't skip.
No shows, huh? Man, so that's gonna be us next year? Feels so soon. What are your plans, Yucatan? College?
I haven't really decided yet. What about you? Oh, really? That's a surprise. You know how the student council president was crying? I can sort of relate, since my dad passed away too. But that stuff she said about seizing opportunities? Give me a break. How does she expect us to know what to do with that? I mean, yeah, it's important, but that's more for people who already know what they want in life. Well, anyway, there's no hurry to decide what we want to do with our lives, right? I mean, I already have so much on my plate right now, you know?
Hmm. Yeah. I guess that's true.
Here's what I think. If life is all about the pursuit of happiness, then knowing the truth isn't everything, right? Sure, we do what we gotta do, but if we're taking a stand on every little thing, there'd be no end to it. In the end, it doesn't matter how you spend your time, as long as you're happy. No one's gonna fault us for choosing to live in the moment, right?
Yeah, guess so. Man, that was some speech.
To be honest, I'm not that strong on my own. And when I feel insecure, I get worked up. It's hard to explain, it's just how I am.
Hey, I get it. Thinking never really gets me anywhere. When that happens, I just go do something fun and forget about it.
You would.
Everyone's so uptight these days. They just need to chill out. You know, take it easy for a change.
What are you gonna do if that plan backfires?
I'll figure something out. But for now, let the good times roll. And on that note, who's down for karaoke, anyone? Let's celebrate our future!
Thanks for the ball.
Celebrating is for the graduates. Well, I'll go if he goes.
Hey, what's with the preferential treatment? Well, now you're coming whether you like it or not. I'll buy you a drink, all right?
Wow. That scene is a little bit different if you date Yukari. Whoa. Junpei teases the two of you and how close you are. Wow. And now we have to wait for the credits so we can see whatever happens after the credits ending or whatever. I like this persona the most, for sure. We'll talk more about it when this is done. We'll talk a little bit about it when the credits and all that and the after scene is done.
Dude, no, we have to get Persona Dancing All Night 2.
Or 3. Did they make 2 Dancing All Night games? It makes it like the third one. I don't know. Whatever. It's 3 now. Super Deluxe Arena. True. I really am excited to eventually play Nocturne for the first time and Vengeance when that comes out. But it's not gonna just be on the Switch. It'd be nice to put another more than just one SMT game on my PC. And SMT3 is gonna be my very first like actual SMT game since I've never played them before. And I really, really want them to bring back Digital Devil Saga so that I can play it on, like, Steam or something. Because I've always wanted to play the DDS so badly when I was growing up. I just never did. Yeah, there's a metaphor that's coming out soon. I hear that, like, at least from Sly, because I was talking to Sly about this, that DDS is more of a classic RPG in terms of classic, or more like simple progression kind of thing. Like, you just kind of get, like, pulled along for the ride kind of thing, with like a big skill tree kind of looking sphere grid, and the fights are still difficult and all that, apparently. So it's like streamlined. I don't know if it has the devour mechanic. I don't really know. I don't know anything about it myself. Yeah, it from what I understand, from what I was talking to him about, it really is just another SMT game. So it has like the usual quirks that those titles will have. I think he said it was also his favorite, like, SMT title. And he's played all of them. He's played SMT 1 through 5, including SMT 4 and Apocalypse, you know what I mean? Like, how they made the new versions of the same game. He's done all that. He's played DDS, he's played all the Persona games and everything, and he's like, I think I like that one the most, because DDS the most. Because it's just, I don't know, something about it, it's just good. Any interest in Soul Hackers? I don't really know much about Soul Hackers. When I saw it, I thought it was a little bit interesting, but then I just kind of was like, maybe if I want to play it sometime in the future, I will, but it's not anytime soon. If I had to pick between any other Atlus title to play next, like a new IP for me, I would play SMT3 first. Soul Hackers is the last thing I'd want to play. I'd even be willing to say that I wouldn't mind waiting for DDS to appear as a remaster or something on Steam and play that before Soul Hackers. Like that's how little interested I am in Soul Hackers compared to the other games. I can definitely wait. I'm patient for that, basically. Yeah, I was talking, when I was talking to Sly about everything, he was telling me that the game, that, like, SMT is the game where you recruit demons, and the demons are in your party, and that they can also, like, fucking die and disappear when they die or something like that. I'm like, what? And that the game is pretty damn hard compared to these other games. Like, Persona's like baby compared to, it's like baby's first SMT kind of thing. So I'm like, wow. That's cool. I never played Devil Survivor. No, I've only played Persona games. I've only played Persona 3 Reload, Persona 4 Golden, and Persona 5. Not 5R, I just played 5. Those are the only games that I've played from this company, I believe. And I guess technically the MMO. Not for very long, though, but I did play SMT Imagine for a little bit when I was a kid. I've said it before when we started this game, and I was also saying it when I was watching Sly stream, that I always loved that this series, even though I've only experienced it through Persona specifically, but I can tell immediately when I first started playing like Persona 4 Golden, that they really make it feel like progression is very important, like. Getting a new spell, like a new debuffing spell, or just an upgraded tier of a spell you have, and all this other stuff is just very, very useful. I love that stuff. All right, here we go. Let's see what happens. Oh God, it's so dark. Wow. Wow. What the hell?